The first thing is discovering our innate divinity, our innate goodness, our innate strength, our innate power and autonomy. And then secondly is, how do we work with our ego? So being human is kind of a crazy thing, because we are inherently divine in our nature, inherently good, inherently beautiful and strong. And yet, layered on top of this, you know, we have an egoic mind. And within our egoic mind, we may have wounds, we may have belief systems, we may have pain from the past, we may have, you know, discursive thoughts, we may have anxiety or all sorts of emotions. And so we work in two ways. The first way is can we discover our innate strength, our innate power, our innate autonomy? And we do that normally through, you know, meditative practices, mindfulness practices, you know, just discovering our innate goodness, and just inquiring into, what is this thing called me? And then beyond that, we look at how does this thing called me, this innate goodness, how is this reflected in my outward life? You know, and here's where most of us get in a little bit of trouble. Because most of us, you know, because our ego is running rampant, it's running out of control, because our ego is all over the place, you know, chasing after hopes or fears, or, you know, has trouble communicating clearly with others because of wounds and pains from the past, we meet our ego with love, with compassion, and with mindfulness. So mindfulness means clear seeing. And so we, from a perspective of mindfulness, we begin to work with our ego and work in a way that's actually helpful. And so we can't work with our ego. We can't change our life unless we first become aware of it. And so part of my job as a therapist is to shine the light into the dark places, you know, the wounded places, the painful places, you know, and coming from a place of love and a place of compassion, we work with healing those places. So sometimes we do deep inner work where we help to heal the wounds of the past, the pains from the past. We help to, you know, sometimes with the light of awareness, we investigate our belief systems and look at how these belief systems are serving us or not serving us, how they're causing problems, how they're causing, you know, suffering in our day-to-day life. You know, we look at, you know, how we communicate with others, how we communicate with our partner, you know, how we communicate with our kids or our boss, how we communicate with ourselves. You know, for example, if someone walked in my office and had, you know, negative belief systems and they're constantly judging themselves or judging others, we might look at the root of that and discover, where did you pick that up from? Perhaps you picked it up from a, you know, a mother or a father, you know, who had a judgmental mind or, you know, a difficult mind. And so we heal that place within us. We meet it with love and compassion. And as we heal that place within us, what we find is what's reflected in our day-to-day life is our innate goodness. So instead of our day-to-day life reflecting thoughts of being judgmental or being argumentative or, you know, getting in conflicts, you know, with our partners or whatever it is, our day-to-day life reflects our innate beauty, our innate goodness, our innate strength and power and autonomy. So these are the types of things we work with in therapy. And so I work with individuals, I work with couples, and whether you're meeting with me in my office or on Skype, because I meet with clients from, you know, all around the world, you know, depending on, you know, what it is you're working with, I'll meet you wherever you're at. And so some people come and they just want to talk about spiritual awakening, they want to talk about energetic blocks, you know, things that are going on in them. You know, some people want to talk about Kundalini awakening. And other people just want to learn how to communicate better with their partner or their children. They want to learn how to, you know, be more kind and gentle with themselves. And to me, it doesn't make any difference. It's all one work. You know, it's our whole life is just a manifestation of where we are. And what that means is, like, there's a supreme intelligence that's ruling this universe, and the supreme intelligence is arranging the events of our life so that our next step is right in front of us. So for some people, their next step is, you know, jumping off the deep end and going, you know, into a, you know, a full-blown spiritual awakening. And for some people, the next step is, you know, how do I communicate clearly with my partner? How do I let go of this grief, you know, about, you know, losing my son or my child? Or how do I let go of this grief that I have from childhood around not having the parent, you know, that I wanted? And so wherever we're at, we work with this. And we just look at, what's our next step? And what would our true self do? What would our divine self do? And how can this divine self be more accurately reflected in our day-to-day life. And so we just work, and we work in this way, in a gentle way, in an open way, but also in an efficient way. And to me, you know, one of the downsides of psychology is if we just focus on psychology, we miss this huge factor that we are also divine, that we are also good. You know, if we just focus on our innate divinity, then we can have our, you know, our psychological shadows running rampant in our life and getting in the way of us living up to our innate potential and our innate divinity. So to me, both are necessary. We need to discover our divinity, our innate goodness, our innate wholeness and our innate completeness, as well as work with our shadow self. When we work with these two together, we become a whole being, you know, who lives in an adult way and whose divinity is reflected in a beautiful way in the world. And so this is my invitation to you. If you like, visit my website. There's all sorts of information on how to schedule a session with me or information about a session. I deeply look forward to meeting with you, whether it's in person, doing a one-on-one session, or one of my workshops or satsangs or retreats that I offer.